In this video, I'm going to show you how to deploy Azure IoT Edge runtime onto a Linux device. And in this demo, I'll be using a Raspberry Pi running Raspbian. But first, I'll illustrate to you what edge computing is all about.
In order to understand what edge computing is all about, we need to first understand the role played by cloud computing in industry. In a typical plant, you'd have machines that are generating data and sending it to the cloud via a gateway that routes the data straight to a storage service or to an analytics software. The job of the analytics software will be to convert the data into something digestible by a real-time dashboard or a machine learning algorithm. In the case of machine learning, the algorithm is trained using the data, and out of that comes a model. A model that describes all things that the machine has experienced in the past. So, this is useful in the sense that you can then use the model in real time, such that when the machine encounters an undesired condition, you can take action before it causes damage by sending a control signal to the machine at the factory floor. So, the idea of edge computing is that instead of sending all the data upstream and have all this activity happen here at the cloud, why not push all of these components to the edge, closer to the factory equipment, so that we can have these decisions made right at the source of the data in order to reduce the cost of transferring data, benefit from unlimited bandwidth, and be able to employ these technologies in mission-critical applications. So to begin, I'll go to my Azure portal and create an IoT hub that will be used for bi-directional communication between the cloud and my edge device. So this communication channel will be used to download Edge modules and perform some basic configurations. Okay, and then when the deployment of my IoT hub is complete, I'll go to the IoT hub to create an Edge device, an IoT Edge device, which is essentially a reflection of the actual device, otherwise known as the device twin, such that when we need to update our Edge device, we update this cloud version instead, and changes will be automatically synced. So we copy its connection string to be used for configuring our Raspberry Pi. Okay, so I've got my Raspberry Pi connected to this monitor here, but I'll be using SSH to remotely access its terminal on my PC. Now, since our Azure IoT Edge runtime and modules are run as Docker containers, we need to have Docker installed on our Edge device. So we'll begin by installing a Docker engine called Mobi, which is officially supported with Azure IoT Edge. When the installation of the Docker engine is complete, we move on to the installation of Azure IoT Edge runtime using the following commands. And then when that is complete, we move on to manually provision the device. We do that by opening the Azure IoT Edge config file and updating the device connection string with the one that we copied earlier in our Azure portal. And then we save and close the file. And then after provisioning the device, we restart the Azure IoT Edge daemon. And then we can check the status of the runtime. And here we can see that our Azure IoT Edge runtime is active and running. Okay, so the next thing that I want to show you is how you can deploy a module onto your Azure IoT Edge runtime. And to do that, I'm going to use a pre-built module that simulates temperature and pressure. So navigate to your IoT hub, go to IoT Edge, go to the device, select set modules, and then click add an IoT Edge module. Enter the name, and then we need to provide the image URI for the module container. So if you build your images into a Docker container, you're then supposed to provide the URI of that image here. Next. So this is our default route that sends all messages to IoT Hub. And then here you can see our temperature sensor module is now listed as part of the modules on our IoT Edge runtime. And then back here on our Raspberry Pi terminal, we can list the modules that are currently running there. And then we'll see we've got our temperature sensor also running. And then finally, we can view the messages that are being generated and sent from our temperature sensor module. And then if we go back to our IoT Hub overview, we should see the messages being sent from the device to the cloud. Thanks for watching. If you've got any thoughts at all on this video, I would love to hear about it in the comment section below. And if you found the video useful, please share it with your connections and don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this.